Lady Gaga έχει βραβευτεί με 12 Grammy, ένα Oscar καλύτερου τραγουδιού. Και σήμερα, στα 34 της χρόνια, έχει μια περιουσία που ξεπερνάει σύμφωνα με το Forbes τα 320 εκατομμύρια δολάρια. Σε ένα υπέροχο σπίτι στους λόφους του Hollywood, θα σας γνωρίσω τώρα τη γυναίκα που ανακάλυψε τη Lady Gaga. Η μουσική παραγωγός Wendy Starland εντόπισε τη διάσημη σήμερα superstar ως Στεφάνια Τζερμανότα να κάνει μια δουλειά γραφείου, της άλλαξε το όνομα και ανέπτυξε σε τέτοιο βαθμό το ταλέντο της που την εκτόξευσε στο παγκόσμιο στερέωμα εκτρονίζοντας τη Μαντόνα. Η ιστορία της Gaga θα μπορούσε να γίνει ταινία.
Wendy, you have worked with many artists besides Lady Gaga that you are known for. Moby, Billy Ray Cyrus, Michael Bolton. Who did you love the most?
I mean, listen, I've certainly had the most experience spending a lot of time with Lady Gaga, which was wonderful. She's so incredibly talented. And I had the most personal experiences with her as well because we, you know, would hang out socially as well and had a really nice friendship.
Let's go back to how you discovered Lady Gaga. Is it true that you were assigned with a task to find a new, fresh talent, someone totally different at the time?
I was working with a multi-platinum producer and living in New York at the time, and I was assigned with the task of going out to find a girl under the age of 25 who could be the lead singer of The Strokes, the female equivalent to the lead singer of The Strokes, who was edgy and bold and you couldn't take your eyes off of, and so I went to every show that I could.
Next up is...
Do you remember the night that you went into the club that you discovered Lady Gaga? How was that night? How was she?
She was incredible, but I actually didn't meet her in a club. I met her at Famous Music Publishing, which is a music publishing company in New York at Viacom, and she was the secretary for the CEO.
And Lady Gaga?
That's right. She was Stephanie Germanotta at the time. And I had no idea she was a singer.
Yes.
And I was, Erwin Robinson was her boss, and I went in to shop my music for a publishing deal. They were interested in potentially signing me to a publishing deal there. It's Viacom's company. And she was...
The secretary.
In the suit behind a desk. And every time I passed her desk, she was very kind and nice. And my space was big at the time, and my music was coming out of her speakers on her desk. I said to myself, okay, who dresses like that? Who, you know, the gay community and the transvestites, the transgender community, wear very elaborate outfits to the nightclubs in New York City, where we were. And it's very imaginative and creative and bold and beautiful. And I said, okay, well, if I'm gonna dress her up like this and she's gonna really own this audience, who's one of the gay icons? So Freddie Mercury of the band Queen. All right, and what's one of the big songs from Queen? Radio Gaga. Okay, I'm gonna steal the Gaga, but it's not a radio, it's a lady, so Lady Gaga.
Multi-talented.
It took years.
Yes.
So the whole development process, it's like a seed in the ground, and then when the flower finally comes out, oh, it happened quickly, but it really...
It was 5-6 years.
No, I wouldn't say it was 5-6 years. But we worked together for quite some time over the years. It takes a village, first of all, to create something that's gonna become a global brand. It's not, it takes one person who is the face of that brand, and she certainly is, and she does an incredible job.
Tell me something, boy. Aren't you tired trying to fill that void?
How did you feel when you see her transforming herself into an actress?
I thought that was very natural, actually. She had been acting, I don't know to what level or to what degree, but she had been acting previously, and that was always an aspiration of hers. And she is very theatrical naturally, which is why the costumes and why the outfits work so organically because this is part of who she is. Gaga is so charismatic, so brilliant, very, very, very smart. She could sell ice to Eskimos. She just has this magical quality about her. She's very New York, which is what I love. I mean, I'm from New York City, and I love people who are really quick like that. Her way with people is just magnetic, and it's unbelievable. I think until you experience it firsthand, you really don't know the extent to just how powerful it is. We're far from the shallow now.